हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू हेफ्स चैनल। यू आर वाचिंग हेल्थ, एनवायरनमेंट, फूड सेफ्टी, फायर सेफ्टी, सस्टेनेबिलिटी सॉल्यूशंस। टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग वेरी वेरी इंफॉर्मेटिव टॉपिक, दैट इज व्हाट इज हाउसकीपिंग, व्हाट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ हाउसकीपिंग, व्हाट इज द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ हाउसकीपिंग, and what is housekeeping safety with sharp objects, and what is preventing slips and trips and falls, and what is a safe lifting and material handling, and what is a safety with chemicals, and in this housekeeping department, how to handle the equipments, how to use as the fire extinguisher in your workplace. That's today we have to discuss. So initially we will be discuss for that what is exactly in definition, what does the housekeeping mean. So in this occupational settings, housekeeping refers to the routine cleaning and organizing of the workplace, and as housekeeping is an ongoing safety practice, orderly conditions in the workplace should be maintained on a consistent basis, not restored after orderliness has been allowed to slip. Housekeeping operations in the workplace are considered to be a fundamental tenet of occupational safety, and as a mandatory workplace safety activities is most juridicous. So in housekeeping, it may be defined as a provision of a clean, comfortable, safe and aesthetically appealing environment. It is operational department in a hotel, workplace, industry, in apartment or buildings, and so all this in surroundings area, which is responsible for cleanliness, maintenance, aesthetic upkeeping of rooms, public areas, back areas and surroundings. It is a doing basic cleaning tasks in a household and other locations, or the department of employees who manage and perform cleaning tasks. So in this house cleaning or housekeeping, that is the disposing of any rubbish, cleaning dirty surfaces, dusting and vacuuming. It may also involve some outdoor chores such as removing leaves from rain gutters, washing windows and sweeping doormats. The term house cleaning is often used also figuratively in politics and business for the removal of unwanted personal methods or policies in effort on a reform of improvement. So in this occupational setting, the cleaning is organized in the workplace. A housekeeping is an ongoing safety practices. So it is a general care, cleanliness, orderliness and maintenance or of business or property. So in this, good housekeeping is an important considerable in underwriting of a fire hazard and other forms of things, insurance, as well as in certification by fire, health and industrial safeties. So housekeeping safety also very very important, how to handle that while cleaning the your equipments, and while dusting that, while remove the dirts. So entirely you have to handle with chemicals, certain chemicals and certain areas with chemicals. So let us discuss for that. In first of all, in that safety topics and safety with what safety exactly in the housekeeping. So let us discuss for this, and safety with sharps. Any sharp items, any scissors or any knives or any things in your area, you have to keep scissor in sharpened, and use proper scissors with the job being done, and don't try to catch it falling scissors, and don't transfer that scissors, and don't touch for improperly, and you have to handle within proper PPE. And you can carry that scissors with the blades closed, and you can keep that certain respected areas, and hand scissors to some handle facing them. So like that, the safety with sharp scissors are very very important in workplace. And when using a box cutter or cut away from yourself, and keep box cutters closer when not in use, and put broken glasses in safe container and mark it. Don't pick up broken glass with your bare hands. You can use in PPE, and you can always wear the correct PPE when cleaning an area. So PPE is a must should be for this. So you have handling that while handling that in any sharps machines or sharp tools. So personal protective is very very important. So while you have to cleaning and before cleaning. So coming to that, keep scissors sharpened, use proper scissors for the job being done, and you can be in, put broken glass in a safe container and mark it, and always wear the PPE. Okay, it's come to cuts. If anything cuts happening in injuries or in cut injuries or anything happen, if you cut yourself, wash the wound thoroughly under cold water. If wound is shallow and the bleeding stops, dry the skin around it with a paper towel or clean cloth. If available, put an infection prevention cream spray on wound in first aid box, and you can cover the wound with a sterile bandage to keep up the wound sealed and clean. And if anything, you know, bleeding is came, to stop the bleeding, if the wound is deep, you can apply pressure, raise the wound, it sit above the heart, seek medical attention as soon as possible in your nearest hospitals. And you know, anybody have to universal precautions. All human blood and certain human bodily fluids are treated as if they are infection for immunovirus, HIV, hepatitis B and other bloodborne pathogens. So should be observed all situation where there is a potential for contact with blood or other potentially infectious material. For your safety, treat all human blood and certain body fluids as if they are infectious. So you can be understand for that precautions for that bloodborne pathogens without cross contamination, one person to another person, one mission to another mission, without transfer the blood or blood particles or clotting particles through air or water. So it is very important while you have to working in your workplace area. So potentially infectious bodily fluids, in that what is the infected bodily fluids means, it's highly hazardous, maybe it will be contaminated, chances also available. So that, what is that means? Blood, saliva, vomit, urine, semen or vaginal secretions, skin, tissue, cell cultures, other body fluids. So you can be assume that all bodily fluids are contaminated with infectious blood. So what exactly in for this control method? In this, you can use protective equipment. Always wear protective gloves when cleaning, or latex gloves or rubber gloves or nitrile gloves, and don't use the not leather or cloth. You can use rubber and nitrile and latex or non-latex if you are allergic. So surgical mask, if bodily fluid are wet, you can use for surgical mask. If bodily fluids are wet, long sleeve shirt, long pants also required for that protective equipment for this activity. And syringe or needles, if you have handled the syringe or needles also, you can don't for this syringe or needles, you can follow this safety precaution. This, do not place hands directly in trash cans containers. When emptying trash cans, keep bag away from the body. And also, if you find a syringe needles, treat as if it is used. Only handle syringe by barrel, never by needle. Okay, place in puncture resistant container as per that occupation health and safety required special red colored containers. Don't throw syringes, syringe disposal containers into dumpsters. It's very, very important for the syringes and needles. And needle sticks also very important. In your workplace or first aid center or hospitals or hotels, in any things, or any needle sticks available in the housekeeping areas, if you pierce or puncture your skin with a used needle, follow this first aid advice immediately. First of all, encourage the wound to be bleed, ideally by holding it under running water. Wash wound using running water and plenty of soap. Don't scrub the wound while you washing. Don't suck the wound. Dry the wound and cover it with waterproof plaster or dressing. Report the incident and get medical attention. So this is a important if in case of puncture your skin with needle sticks. And you can be immediately report on the job injuries, workplace injuries, incidents or accidents to the concerned supervisor or concerned department. You have to report any job injuries to your supervisor as soon as possible and make sure an injury report is completed as soon as possible as per that details. And also next in this housekeeping, preventing the slips, trips, falls. If you're working in that floor cleaning, we have to follow that certain precautions. You have to initially where you have to cleaning, how the process cleaning, and what exactly signage boards is required. We should be understand for that, is it slippery area, what PPE is happening, what chemicals is using. So all this you should be understand and before start the work. In this fall hazards, there is a slip and fall hazards, two types of falls and the same level, high frequency, low severity, and from elevators, low frequency and high severity. There is a two types in falls on same level from elevators. So it is a causes that wet or slippery area, oil floors and staircases are loose irregular surfaces such as a rock, racks, and insufficient light. Also it happens for this slip hazards and uneven walkways and sidewalks also it will be happen. And shoes with slick soles or raised heels and moving too fast and carrying items impair balance, obstruct vision, and objects, any objects is stuck or paper clips or food. So poor housekeeping is very, very major step for this, in case this for causes for poor housekeeping. And loose handrails, uncovered unguarded pits, floor openings, and improper ladder usage also. And for this shifting floor tiles causes, not watching while walking or moving, and spilled liquids and cords across walkways. So for this, what can we do, what to do, means this is the only thing. You have to, prevention is better than cure. You have to prevent. Prevention is main. So what prevention, what to do, means there is a four steps is available. First is the find the problem and hazard. Where is exactly problem is there? You have to find out. Hazard means if anything, slip hazard means it, in case of anything risk happening, it will be leads the any cut hazards or anything puncturing or anything skin puncturing, anything happening bleeding, it will be effect for that hazards. So because of slip hazard, so for this we can take for that prevention, in that any hazards happening, we have to, prevention is very, very important in a housekeeping department. So you have to follow the four steps in this. Number one, find the problem and check it out. What exactly you have to monitor thoroughly, you have to check it, you have to inspect, and you have to fix it. Third option. Fourth is a look at it again. You have to repeatedly understand and what exactly, where it is happening, how it is happening, how to mitigate this problem. You have to look it again and again. for this process. So in step one, what is the find the problem means, is the area or wet area or dry area or slippery area or clutter area, and our employees are moving too quickly. You can check for all these points, and is this area poorly lit or is there area in machineries or tools is randomly, is there are anything, you know, proper order is there or not, what is the condition of poor, and are stairs steep or are in poor condition. You just check it for entire that problems, what exactly in this area. That is step one. If any problem, suppose any exits or walkways clutter or more lighting is not there, and illumination problem or luxor problem or hand grills problem or rust problems or repair problems, so wherever that problem you have, you have to point out and you have to report and focus, and same to be how to inform to their concern department managers. And you have to check for that in steps area, you have to check for that in handrails are present, or any unguarded edges or openings, or any layouts make a slip or trip or fall situations. So all that in your UPS area, DG room area, workplace area, staircase area, guards area, gardening area, your workplace area. So entirely how to workplaces and industries or plants and all departments and all hotels, rooms and inside and outside. You can check for the entire that what exactly problem, how the will be, you know, mitigate. You have to check for that in all there in cards across the walkways. So any wires or anything openings is there, you just check it for that, and you have to find out the problem, make it report, and you have to resolve for that accordingly as per your roundings. And what about exactly in this, see, in any walkways or any cards or across is there, you just check it. Or any electrical wires also you have to find out. And second step, check it out. Check it out is very important. You know, you have to do for that, you know, daily walking around in workplace. You have to check and monitor, is the problem area near moving machinery or anything high traffic, is the area properly lit, are employees wearing the proper footwear, and which is safer for work. So you have to check for that all this area, you have to check it for that, is it a safety shoe is followed or nothing, PPE is followed or not, so what type of PPE is doing, so what is a safer for that PPE, what the PPE standards. You just check for that every area, every PPE equipments, PPE selection, PPE evaluation, PPE effectiveness. Suppose the safety shoe is there, is it a grippery shoes or is a safe shoes or safety shoes, you can check for that as per that standards. So like that you have to check for that everything. And in these checkpoints or wet floor, is signboard is available or not, is a signboard, is it place is maintained or not, like work in progress. Like that you have to follow in that wet floor or you have to working in wet floor area, you have to follow that signage board, yellow color signage board. And the floors being is mopped is a as per schedule or as per that your timeline or not, and is walking surface more slippery due to its construction, you just check it for that, you know, in this floor area is slippery or how it is a condition. And is it area outside and subject to the weather? So is it outside and subject to weather or not? So step three is the fix it. Then after checking, you have to fix it that, oh, the problem is in here. You have to fix it. So accordingly, you have to possible to eliminate. So if possible, eliminate or control methods or hazard immediately, like example, having spills wiped up. And if not possible, take steps to alert people and then determine what can be done and eliminate or control the hazards. So like that, you have to alert for that. If unable to fix quickly, alert people. So you have to display the caution boards and display the standard operating procedures. And you have to given the trainings. So accordingly, the people will be alert. The fourth one is the look at it again. Look at it again. Ensure that all hazards and problems and repaired and eliminated and are controlled. And anything you have to look at again. And if anything problem is there, you have to check for that periodically to ensure that hazards or problem does not return or not. Then determine if any trainings is required or training job process trainings is required or not. You just affect how many employees is affected for this machinery or workplace area, and you should be appropriate signage be posted or not. So you have to look at for all these concerns. So find the problem, you have to check it, you have to fix it, and you have to look it again. These are four steps is very very important of prevention measures. So come to prevention measures, install the non-slip tape or any grip cleats or staircases, and have one hand free and use handrails when walking up or downstairs. Store objects on shelves or in a cabinets, not in aisles or walkways. Don't run while working, and ensure walkways are kept clear and unobstructed. And also in housekeeping, it's a very very important stairs or steps. Stair safety is very important. In stair safety, you have to, when you cleaning that, when you walking that, you definitely, you know, proper safely is very important. Non-slip threads on stair edges also is there, and reflecting edging on last step. You can be marking for that edges for that, and you have to walk with support of the guardrail. So that's stair safety is very important. You have to, prevention is important. You wear the proper PPE and wear proper footwear, and don't run or move quickly while walking, and have leaks or spills cleaned up the quickly. Place caution tape or uneven drop off areas, and develop and put into a place a ladder safety and inspection program. So wearing the proper footwear, so wear shoes with a slip resistance soles or traction devices when walking or working on surfaces that are wet, greasy, icy, or otherwise slick. And no footwear has anti-slip properties for every condition. So you can check for that, you know, footwear, you know, is anti-slip resistance are available or not. Practically, you can select that proper type of footwear for the work conditions and the type of flooring or walking or working surface. So slip resistance traction devices for snow and or ice that if over the soles. So like that, you have to PP selection and evaluation is very important. So the prevention is that to any prevention, have wet floors is signs are posted where the necessary. Thoroughly investigate all slips and trips and falls. Apply non-skid coating or place non-skid strips in areas where floors are likely to be slippery or wet. So report hazardous situations as soon as possible. So pick up the objects that have been fallen on the floor, example food, paper or clips or anything, and have carpets or rugs and mats secured to the floor and taped down raised ends. And always close file cabinet drawers, and don't place delivery carts in the middle of an aisle or walkways. So falling properly. So if you do fall, you can reduce the chance of the serious injury. If you roll with the fall, don't reach out. Let your body crumple and roll. Bend your elbows and knees and use your legs and arms to observe the fall. So get medical attention after a fall to treat anything torn, sprained or broken. And what may have happened? So running, you have to quickly to running downstairs, not using the handrails and shoe laces untied. So objects on stairs above, it is a major risk. So that is the reason you have to follow the certain precautions in this while you have to cleaning and while you have to down the stairs and use for that handrails. and follow that proper safety shoes, rules and regulations. So what exactly objects on stairs above, what SOPs is happening, you can check for that in notice boards, anything safety precaution is available. So accordingly, how to follow that in workplace safety precautions in housekeeping area. And also in housekeeping, especially main part is the safe lifting and material handling is very important. So the safe lifting and material handling is that there is a tips is available. What is the process? You have to check the object before attempted lift. So whatever the item, whatever that housekeeping material, you just be check the object before you have to attempt to lift it. And test every load before lifting. It's called pushing object lightly with hands or feet to see how easily it moves. Good indication as to how heavy it is. So remember, a small size does not always mean a light load. So make sure that load you are lifting is packed correctly. Employees packing boxes should make sure weight is balanced and packed so it would not move around. Loose pieces inside a box can cause accidents if the box becomes unbalanced. So make sure the load is easy to reach and don't arc your back when lifting a load over your head. Use a ladder instead of lifting something over your head. So is the best way to pick an object, use slow and smooth movements, and hurried jerky movements can strain the muscles in your back. So don't go for that jerk movements and hurried. It will be strain the muscles in your back and risk. So that is the reason, use slow and smooth movements. Keep your body facing in the object while you lift it. Twisting while lifting can injure your work. So main important, test the load. Always test the load before lifting to ensure it's not too heavy for you to lift any carry by yourself. Any cotton boxes, any housekeeping boxes, any material, anything. If you always test the load before lifting that. And if you determine the load is too heavy, get assistance. Either by using people or appropriate mechanical aid, you can use for that trolleys and with buddy systems. You can accordingly load. So you have to planning ahead. Before moving a load, plan both the load and the route. Always you to avoid the hazards. So when you receiving that material while moving that load with that with van or anything, moving load plan or anything machinery, you can be check for that before moving a load, plan both the load and the route. Allows you to evaluate the hazards, limitations, route safety and final placement. So evaluate the weight and shape of the load and also what material is made of. Some items to check, you have to, is it personal protective equipment or any other safety gear necessary, is that any size or shape, weight within limits. So you can get form and hand hold, or will you able to see over the load. So will you need assistance, people or cart. So you have to plan accordingly for this. So back injury prevention, plan your lift. So think about the weight, size and shape of the object and the distance you will be moving at. Is the object bulky? Will you need help? Do you see any hazards that can be eliminated? So think about the route you will be taking, any stairs or doors or obstacles. So if the object is heavy or not, plan your lift accordingly, you have to follow. And planning ahead the route, check the route you will take, that place where you will put the load down. Injuries and property damage can occur when unexpected problems happen during the move. You have to consider the routes. Are there steps or tripping hazards, closed doors, tight doorways or passageways? So are there any blind corners or wet or slippery floors is available? What is the traffic situation, people or tables or any workplace areas? So you have to consider planning ahead the drop off point. So some concentration for that. So where will you place the load? Is there room for the load? Is that proper condition is available? And is the site strong enough to hold the load? So with a load black traffic or create a hazard when placed. So will the load have to be any placed to elsewhere, or will be it be in the right location after you set it down? So lowering the object. So when you handling anything, you know, manual handling any equipment, there is a correct position is available. So when lowering an object, remember to bend at the knees, not at the waist. You can bend at the knees, not at the waist. So at the avoid twisting motions while putting the load down. So it is a correct ergonomic posture. So you have to follow the proper manual handling procedures or equipment handling procedure. If you must turn while lowering an object, adjust your feet rather than twisting your back. So lifting properly is the step one, is that stand close to the load with your feet spread about shoulder width apart, one foot slightly in front of the other for balance. And the step two is that lifting properly, squat down bending at the knees, not your waist. Tuck your chin while keeping your back as vertical as possible. And step three in lifting properly, get a firm grasp on the object before beginning the lift. And step four in lifting properly, begin slowly lifting within your legs by straightening them, never twist your body during this step. And step five, once lift is complete, keep object as close to your body as soon possible. As load is center of gravity, moves away from body, dramatic increase in stress and to lumbar region of the back. And step five, so is also very important. And so if anything objects is there, you have to bending over at the waist and having lifting from below knees, improper postures. So is all in this, you have to follow the in safe manner. Okay, so strengthening exercise. So for this you have to strengthen yourself, you have to strengthen your exercise in your body fit. So wall slides to strengthen your muscles. Stand with your back against a wall, feet shoulder width apart, slide down into a crouch with knees bent to 90 degrees centigrade, count to 5 and slide back up to the wall, repeat 5 times. And you have to stretching exercise is important, gastro stretch. So lean against a wall or other stationary object, both palms against the object. Leg your want to stretch his back several feet from wall, heel firmly positioned on the floor. Other leg is flexed about halfway between back leg and wall. Start with your back straight and gradually lung forward until you feel the stretch in your calf. Very important to keep back foot straight at an angle 90 degrees from the wall. For stretches, the side of neck, sit and stand with arms hanging loosely at sides. Turn head to one side, then other. Hold for 5 seconds each side. Repeat 1, 2, 3 times. Stretches for side of shoulder and back of upper arms. Stand or sit and place right hand and left shoulder. And with left hand, pull right elbow across the chest toward left shoulder and hold 10 to 15 seconds. So you have to same repeatedly other side. And finally, stretches for triceps, top of shoulders, waist. Keep knees slightly flexed. Stand or sit with arms overhead. Hold elbow with the hand of opposite arm. Pull elbow behind head gently as you slowly lean to side until mild stretch is felt. Hold 10 to 15 seconds. Repeat same other side. So in housekeeping, there is a very, very important chemical safety, what exactly chemicals and what food service chemicals and what is the housekeeping chemicals and pesticide chemical. There are often many chemicals in the food service environment, such as a drain cleaners, bleaches, surface cleaners, degreasers and floor cleaners and pesticides chemicals. So chemicals can be harmful to your health and environment. Always use caution when working with any chemical. So never mix Coming to chemical safety, you never mix the chemicals together. A violent reactions could occur, causing injury or damage. You can store flammable chemicals in cabinets designed for safe storage. And if chemicals are stored in the kitchen, store on shelves before foodstuffs. So if they leak, they will not contaminate food. So wear appropriate PPE when using chemicals. So next, what is how many types of PPE? You can eye protection such as a safety goggles, important. Hand protection such as a rubber gloves, important. Respiratory protection, face mask is very, very important. Chemical safety in the housekeeping department, chemical safety is a major role. You can handle very carefully in chemical storage area with proper chemical manufacturing instructions while handling, while receiving, while cleaning, while storing. So make sure chemicals are properly labeled and appropriate containers. You can check for that all labels for that manufacturing instructions. Is that appropriate containers is properly stored or not? And you can read all following warning labels in chemical safety norms and housekeeping chemicals. If any available, review corresponding safety data sheet, material safety data sheet before working with chemicals. You can follow the manufacturing recommendations when mixing the water with chemicals. In chemical safety, wash hands thoroughly after using any chemicals. Ensure lids are placed back on chemicals contents when you are done using them. So dispose of used chemicals containers safely. Follow your establishment procedure. Don't store pesticide and other chemicals together in same area. So all chemical safety, clean up all spills immediately and dispose of cleanup material properly. And you have to ensure areas are well and ventilated when using chemicals. And if you feel sick while using a chemical, get to fresh air and have your supervisor notified as soon as possible. Report any injuries or physical reactions you may be when using the chemical immediately. And you have to review yourself and understand the chemicals, how to use, why, because never don't mix chemicals. And you have to read warning labels and SDGs, and also you can check the material safety data sheets, and you can wear the appropriate PPE. Ensure chemicals are properly labeled. You can store chemicals safely. Clean up spills immediately. Notify your supervisor if anything injured. You can remember for this, use common sense and good safety practices when working with chemicals. So never become a complacent when working with any chemical. Chemicals have the potential to harm you or environment. Be careful, be safe, be happy for this chemical. So in this chemical, in case of anything is there in housekeeping, every person, every housekeeping boy or chambermaid or any facilities executive or soft service executive, housekeeping lady or housekeeping gent or an housekeeping supervisor, you must and should be understand for that in a fire extinguisher operations, while cleaning or anything, in case of anything deviation happening. The fire extinguisher is, you know, everybody have to, it's a simple funda. You can check for that, is it a fire extinguisher is how to use and is the recharging or not. I think it's not is a correct place is marking or not. So you just check for all these labels for, you know, fire extinguisher classifications, A type, B type and C type and things. You can understand the class of the fires as a housekeeping person. Class A, ordinary combustible, so is a wood and paper, rubber, and if anything is fire is happening, you have to use for class A. And class B, flammable liquids, gases like gasoline or methane. And class C, energized electrical appliances are plugged in. Class D, fires combustible metal, example titanium and aluminum. So extinguishers for these classes of fire often specific for type metal in question, no picture, designator, no rating. So class K is a very important, is for especially class K fires occurs in cooking grease made from animal fat in kitchen industry, for the classes K fire is mostly using. So these fires usually burn very hot and can be dangerous to extinguish. So there are the specific fire extinguishers that are used for those types of fires, and usually in kitchen areas of restaurants and cafeteria, class K fires. क्लास के लुक्स लाइक इज अ 2.5 gallon प्रेजराइज वाटर एक्सटिंक्शर, डोंट गेट दम मिक्सड अप एंड यूज द लेबल्स मार्किंग्स ऑन ऑल एक्सटिंक्शर्स टू एनश्योर योर करेक्ट वन. सो वॉट इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ द एक्सटिंक्शर ऑपरेटिंग, यूज हाउ टू यूज मीन्स फायर एक्सटिंक्शर. इट इज अ टेक्निक इज दट PASS मेथड. पास पास मीन्स पी मीन्स पुल द पिन ऑन द फायर एक्सटिंक्शर हैंडल. ए मीन्स एम द नॉजिल हॉर्न एंड ऑफ द एक्सटिंक्शर ऑन द बेस एंड बॉटम द फायर. एंड स्क्वीज, एस मीन्स स्क्वीज द फायर एक्सटिंक्शर हैंडल्स टुगेदर एंड मेक द एक्सटिंक्शर वर्क. एंड एस मीन्स स्वीप द एक्सटिंक्शर फ्रॉम साइड टू साइड एज इफ यू आर यूजिंग ए ब्रूम. सो दैट इज अ पास टेक्निक इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. पुल द पिन, एम द नॉजिल, स्क्वीज द फायर एक्सटिंक्शर हैंडल टुगेदर एंड स्वीप द एक्सटिंक्शर फ्रॉम साइड टू साइड. सो दैट इज अ यूज ऑफ योर फायर एक्सटिंक्शर्स. So fire extinguisher, never put a fire extinguisher that's been used back in place, even it is still feels heavy. Even short burst can cause fire extinguisher to leak the pressure after use. Putting a used extinguisher back in place can mean it would not work in future. Have used extinguisher checked and recharged by a reputable dealer. You can check for that extinguisher is that due date and inspection date for that monthly once. So never put it fire extinguisher been used for back in place. So always report anything in case of anything happens in housekeeping workplace area, anything you have to report fires. In case of anything fire are happening, you can report immediately in your concerned department and fire department. Use only proper class of fire extinguisher for the fire you are trying to extinguish, if you have trained or if you have knowledge. So without knowledge you don't handle that fire safety equipments or fire extinguishers. If the fire seems too large for your handle, leave the area closing doors as soon as exit. Notify others in the area so that they can safely evacuate. And never place a used fire extinguisher back in its place. It needs to be checked and recharged. So general safety of buffers. Buffers, don't use the buffers unless you have been trained. Read the manufacturing instructions to become completely familiar with buffers used. Wear long pants and slip resistant shoes when using a buffer. Check cords or electrical buffers for damage or don't use if frayed, cut or damaged. Don't ride on buffer unless designated for that purpose. So get a good grip on the handle to maintain the control of the machines. So buffers that are the damaged or need to prepare should be placed out of the service and tagged. So don't run the floor buffer over electrical cords, door stops or other obstructions. Unplug an attended floor buffer. Don't yank on electrical cord to disconnect a floor buffer. Unplug the floor buffer before changing the buffing pad or cleaning block. So never try to move the floor buffer by pulling on the electrical cord. Carefully operate a floor buffer across changes in the floor surface texture to prevent the strong pulling motions. So cleaning solution used in the floor buffer may leave wet floor surfaces. Post signages warning or wet floors are near the area. And never use propane powered buffers in the enclosed areas. So overall, the safe actions save lives in housekeeping. So always use a safe procedures, methods, never take shortcuts, and you have to use the appropriate safety equipment, and you can use for proper footwear, proper PPE. Think before you lift anything and report safety hazards to your supervisor, manager as soon as possible. Think safety all the time, every time. Be safe, be healthy. Thank you. Thanks a lot.